Long, long ago, Iguana was a proud creature. He was too proud to speak to the other animals. He held his head high and would only nod to them. Iguana and dog were also nodding acquaintances, but with a difference. Old woman sings plaintively from afar, enters through the audience, basket on head. Old woman also has a rhythm. She enters her kitchen complaining of work.
Work for the night is coming. Man's work is done. No one said nothing about when woman work is done. I have to chip and grate the coconut. I have to knead the dough and roll the bread and buns and bake them. I also have to clean the fish and fry them. Between those times, I have to clean the kitchen. The woman's work is never done.
Dog came to the kitchen every day to see how sales are going and to chill out for what might be left. When Dog came to the kitchen, he wanted to know that the old woman was there. So to draw her attention to him, he would rub against her leg. This annoyed the old woman very much.
Look here, dog. No bother me today. Let's go. Get. Oh, I was hurt.
Iguana wanted to be more than a nodding acquaintance to Dog. He longed to be on speaking terms. The next day, he tried again.
Good morning, Dog. How are you doing? Where are you going? This dog won't talk to me. He won't tell me where he's going. I will follow him and see for myself.
Let's go. Iguana was hiding nearby. He heard Dog, but did not know he was getting a kiss beating. He longed even more to be in Dog's company. On the third day, when Dog passed by, Iguana tried again.
Hello, Dog. Where are you going?
You see, I'm going to visit a poor old woman. She has no relatives, so I often go there to keep her company.
You're just the same as I am. I like to keep old woman's company. Oh, I often hear you when I pass by.
Oh, yes. I suppose you hear me. She tells such funny jokes, and I am obliged to laugh.
Take me with you, so that I can help you keep old man's company and listen to some of her funny stories.
I cannot escape from this iguana. He is always bothering me. I will teach him a lesson. A lesson not to force himself on others. Come on, iguana. Get on my back. And hold on tightly. Whatever happens, hold on tightly.
Rain, everything is wet. Lord, please do not give us more than we can bear. Oh, Lord, the fish is burnt. Oh, Lord, what a day. It has rained all through the night. The roof of the kitchen is leaking like a sieve. Everything is wet. The fire heart is wet. The wood is wet. And smoking. Sat for a while and the fish is burnt. On top of that, the bun will not rise. Lord, please do not test me beyond my endurance.
Dog entered the old woman's kitchen and rubbed hard against the old woman's legs. The bony ridge on the iguana's back scratched the old woman's legs. She became angry.
Do not bother me today, dog. You are hunching your back at me, you disrespectful dog. You are ungrateful. Did you see that? I saw upstandness come out of that dog. So help me.
Thank you so much for watching our video on Dog and Iguana by Gladys Stewart. Our group members are Derek Barrow, who played as the old lady, Ronan Solis, and Wilburn Forbes, who played as the iguana. Steven Sylvester, and Jalen Quilter, who played as a dog, Alex Nunez, who narrated the story, and last but not least, Augusto Quinto, who is editing and the cameraman.